Hello, children. We thank God for meeting again. Before we start our lesson, get a piece of paper, empty plastic bottle, a table or chair. Our main topic for today is forces and movements. And you know that movement is caused by applied forces due to the release of stored energy. By the end of the lesson, you'll be able to discover the effects of forces on objects. Identify that forces can also change a shape of an object. A force is an energy applied to an object to change its position, shape, or its direction. Let's try the activities. I told you to get a piece of paper, bottle, table, or chair. So let's use this to apply the or try the activity. Scramble the piece of paper. Push an object, that's the table or a chair. Squeeze an empty plastic bottle. I hope you are done with this. What did you notice in the three activities above? Did the object change shape, direction, or position? Yes. So let's go on. Look at my own. Let's look at a picture here. The scramble of paper. What do you see? The paper changed its shape because of the force that we apply on it. Let's look at the next picture. What is the boy doing? Good. Kicking the ball. So if you kick a ball, it will move. And this makes the ball change its position. So it also requires force. Yes? What do you see here? The little girl pushing a table. So if you push a table, it will only move when you apply forces to overcome that of the table. Therefore, if you push a table with a bigger force, it will move. Pushing a table requires force. And pushing something, it means pushing it away from you. Let's go to the next one. Pulling. Yes. If you pull a rope, it will move when you apply force on it. So pulling a rope also requires force. Pulling something means pulling it to your side. That's the pulling. The next picture, squeezing, the bottle that we squeeze. Yes, when you squeeze an empty bottle, it changes its shape and it also requires forces. So, let's use some of the force to do this or see what will apply to the objects. One, it changes the shape of an object. Two, make objects move. Three, change the direction of a moving object. Reduce the speed of a moving object. And the last one, cause a moving object to stop. So children, we learned about force, how we apply force on objects. And what did you notice? Did the shape changes? Yes, the paper, the bottle, and the table, pull, the rope, all these are force. It changed its direction. So children, that's our end of a lesson today about the force. So you can also keep on try it at home and see the results. Thank you. Meet again.